إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونستهديه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. ثم أما بعد، my beloved brothers and sisters, everybody knows that our existence in this life is not for good. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he always reminding us, and we have to be very careful when Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who is the messenger from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so whenever he give us any advice, we have to be very careful in understanding that advice. And to have a pause, you have to stop to read that advice, that message came from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, from Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. If we are a true believer, there's a difference between a Muslim and a mu'min. Everybody, we have millions of Muslims, but they are, few of them are mu'mineen. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, always, when he pointed any advices, he always think about the mu'mineen. If we are a true believers, we have to know exactly where we are standing and what are the characters of a true believer. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in al-Quran al-Kareem, in Surah al-Anfal, he said, إِنَّمَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ, just listen carefully, إِنَّمَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ الَّذِينَ إِذَا ذُكِرَ اللَّهُ وَجِلَتْ قُلُوبُهُمْ. This is the first characteristic about a mu'min, a true believer, that whenever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala dhikr comes out, wajilat qulubuhum, that immediately your heart will be touched. You will feel something touchy. إِنَّمَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ الَّذِينَ إِذَا ذُكِرَ اللَّهُ وَجِلَتْ قُلُوبُهُمْ وَإِذَا تُلِيَتْ عَلَيْهِمْ آيَاتُهُ زَادَتْهُمْ إِيمَانًا. And whenever آيات Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's word being reminded to you, you will be increasing your beliefs and your iman will go up. وَعَلَىٰ رَبِّهِمْ يَتَوَكَّلُونَ. This is another characteristic. ذكر آيات and وَعَلَىٰ رَبِّهِمْ يَتَوَكَّلُونَ. That whatever we are doing, we always point our aim and our ikhlas towards what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is letting us to go. It's not a choice. To pray Fajr is not a choice. You don't have the choice to pray Fajr, because if it is a choice, so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala having the right to punish you and to take you to Jahannam, because prayers is a must. And this is what ever a new Muslim or a new revert from different religions converted or revert to a Muslim or to Islam, he or she should understand that Salat is not a choice. Salat is a must. And this is what always I'm saying to our brothers and sisters. Let your kids from the start, when they were kids, don't ever listen to those people who said, why on earth you brought up your kids? They will disturb masjid. Of course, we parents are responsible to look after our kids' disturbance in masjid. But on the other hand, we have to encourage young generations. They are far away. All of us are suffering nowadays about the young generation, the new generation, how to bring them in to obey our commands as parents. Prior to this, you have to remember that they have to learn how to obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's command. الذين يقيمون الصلاة. This is another character of those true believers الذين يقيمون الصلاة ومما رزقناهم ينفقون. That Allah سبحانه وتعالى He is the one who provide you with rizq. So you have to spend that rizq which is not your thing you own it. It's Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who provided to you. Who are they? أُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ حَقًّا. They are the true believers. أُولَٰئِكَ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ حَقًّا. What will be the result if you are a true believer? لهم درجات عند ربهم ومغفرة ورزق كريم. لهم درجات عند ربهم. This is the core things. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when He provide you or inflict and give you a painful experience, to lose a beloved ones, to lose your mother, or to lose your father, or to lose your kids, or to lose somebody who is really beloved to you, immediately you have to think that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because He loves you, He is testing you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in this life, we are in a big hole of exam. This is not our life. Our life starts when the moments we going to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala after our demise, after our death. It's a true. My beloved brothers and sisters, don't go away from the concept of death. Because Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in hadith, he said, أكثر من ذكر هادم اللذات. He didn't say, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, just remember death. No, he said, continuously, أكثر من ذكر هادم اللذات. Why? Because the more you remember your day to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you will work extensively. The way how you woke up in the morning to take your kids, to put them, to place them in the school, and straight away you will go to your work to put your fingerprints on time. This is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants from us, that we have to work very extensively, hard, in this way, in this life, to meet Him properly. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in al-hadith, a very amazing hadith. Wallahi al-azim. For the last few days, I'm just reading this hadith. It's one of those beautiful hadith Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said. عجباً لأمر المؤمن. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, he's amazed. عجباً لأمر المؤمن. إن أمره كله خير. Each and every single matter happened to you in this life is always خير. وليس ذاك لأحد إلا للمؤمن. And that matters regardless being a beautiful one or a sad moment. It is only for مؤمن. What is the difference between both of them? وليس ذاك لأحد إلا للمؤمن. إن أصابته سراء شكر. Each and every single individual, whenever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave you a successful result for whatsoever you did, immediately you have to go back and say Alhamdulillah, because that success is not because of you. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He is the one behind that success for you. This is why don't be an arrogant human being whom you pointed the success to yourself. And it's very true. Nowadays, our kids in the school, you have to show them, because they make tawakkul with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is why when they studied, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave them the good results. On the other hand, وَإِنْ شَكَرْ فَكَانَ خَيْرًا لَهُ وَإِنْ أَصَابَتْهُ ضَرَّاءَ صَبَرْ فَكَانَ خَيْرًا لَهُ. And this is the cornerstone. All of us, it's something basic. If I provide you with good things, you will be happy and you will be thankful to me. The most important thing is that whenever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forcefully gave you a painful experience, it's not necessarily to have pain in your body. But most of us lost their beloved one, and it's emotional pain we are going through. Immediately you have to remember the reward Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you if you are patient enough to go back. إِنَّمَا يُوَفَّى الصَّابِرُونَ أَجْرَهُمْ بِغَيْرِ حِسَابٍ. The tafsir of this ayah, one of them they said, for salat, the amount of your concentration in salat, you will be rewarded. For your zakat, for your sadaqah, as well as for your hajj. The only uncountable hasanat will be in your credit is as-sabr. To be patient enough, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, إِنَّمَا يُوَفَّى الصَّابِرُونَ أَجْرَهُمْ بِغَيْرِ حِسَابٍ. Believe it or not, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you a huge amount of hasanat in your account. This is why on the day of judgment, those people who were never go through calamities or ibtilaat, they are watching those people whom they've been tested by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with ibtilaat, with calamities in dunya, and they were so much into this, they wish if they would have in their shoes to have that ibtilaat. To conclude, my brothers and sisters, today's khutbah is about how to be patient, how to have the character being a mu'min, and to teach your friends, to teach your kids a difference between a Muslim and a true believer. Because this is the difference. If you are a true believer, you will always looking forward to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, من أحب لقاء الله أحب الله لقاءه. Look at the condition. من أحب لقاء الله. You have to love, you have to look forward for the pleasing moment to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves us. This is something you have to have it for granted. The condition is that you have to love, you have to look forward to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will love to meet you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves us all, but we have to show him how much we love him and how much we have to be a true believer. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم أجمعين. ثم ما بعد. Few days, let's say, because this religion is a practical religion. I'm reminding myself and you, my brothers and sisters, almost 60 days remaining to meet Ramadan. In 2 days, Rajab will come. Month of Rajab, and after Rajab is Sha'ban. We are talking about 60 days, more or less, to plus or minus 2 days. So, from the moment, from today, show Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala you are looking forward for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves his own abid, his own ibad, those tawabin. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tawbah. Tawbah will be there for you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he will be so much happy whenever you raise your hand and ask tawbah. Don't let shaitan to take you down, and always shaitan coming and whispering in your ears that Allah will not accept your tawbah. No way. As far as you are not mushrik, whatever sin you committed, this is a contract between you and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So don't let a moment goes away if you commit a sin without asking tawbah. In 60 days, we will meet Ramadan. We will meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the month of maghfirah, the month of rahmah. So how we have to prepare ourselves? It's a major sort of an exercise and a course. Nowadays, the daytime is shorter than the night time. So Fajr at 5:20, Maghrib at 5:20. So we are talking about almost 10-12 hours. And the weather is great. This is the time, have a trial of a fast. Fast for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Make sure that if you in your holidays or in your off days, try to have 1 or 2 days to break the fast with your family. Let your kids learn how to fast for the coming Ramadan. Let's prepare ourselves, because don't suddenly you will find yourself in the first day of Ramadan and headache started, and your emotions will be totally different. From now, start to meet, because we don't have the guarantee that we will meet Ramadan this year. Maybe I am here at this moment, but I'm not sure if I will be here next coming Ramadan. But because I have ihsan of dhan that Ya Rabb, let us meet you in Ramadan and show Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from now. Number one. Number two, try from now to make a minimum of 2 khatmas. 1 khatma per month. Because if you are a true believer, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves to hear you reading Al-Quran, to hear you reading His words. Let me give you a suggestion for you and for your wife, for your spouse, for your kids. We don't want more than 15 minutes. It's a must. You are. It's a must to eat. It's a must to go to the toilet. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who provides you with all those things. Give Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala 15 minutes out of 24 hours. Open His book from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Al-Quran Kareem, and read only 15 minutes. Every day, 15 minutes, not more than 15 minutes. If you would like to go more, but don't let a day to pass without a 15 minutes meeting Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's word. Put off your mobile, put it in silent mode, take it off away from you, only for 15 minutes. Believe it or not, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reward you for those 15 minutes. First of all, each and every single harf you will read, you will be rewarded hasanat from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Number two, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knew that you did it for His sake. You did it not for anybody's sake. Number three, you have to remember that 15 minutes, it will be there in your grave. In your grave, when you will be alone that night in that hole on earth, because that 15 minutes will come and will be the lawyer in the front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, said that, Ya Rabb, this guy and this lady were reading your words. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you a lot of rewards. That 15 minutes, my dear brothers and sisters, try it for a month. Believe it or not, you will not withstand a day without 15 minutes. Teach your kids. When your kids grow up with that 15 minutes concept of reading Al-Quran Al-Kareem, you will be rewarded at your grave, that whatever you build in your kids, it will come to your account. So fasting Quran, and again, try from now on for 60 days, 1 KD a day. Just make it a sadaqah. Nobody knows about that 1 KD. Even 100 fils for your kids to show them how they can be making sadaqat. So when 1 KD is nothing, it will go back to your account of hasanat. It will be there on the day of judgment. Al-mu'min fi dhilli sadaqatihi yawm al-qiyamah. That sadaqah which you don't even think about 1 KD is too much, no, it will be there because you did it for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I'm just giving you certain or some points which is easy, but shaitan will come and he will be taking care of you, not to let you to make a lot of hasanat in your account. اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين وأذل الشرك والمشركين ودمر اللهم أعداء الدين. اللهم انصر من نصر هذا الدين واخذ من خذل هذا الدين. اللهم لا تسلط علينا بذنوبنا من لا يخافك فينا ولا يرحمنا. اللهم يا رب العالمين نسألك المغفرة في الدنيا والآخرة. اللهم اغفر للمؤمنين والمؤمنات والمسلمين والمسلمات الأحياء منهم والأموات. اللهم وعافي وشافي جميع مرضى المسلمين. اللهم عافي وشافي جميع مرضى المسلمين. اللهم عافي وشافي جميع مرضى المسلمين. يا رب العالمين بلغنا رمضان هذا العام. اللهم اجعلنا ممن يصوم رمضان ويقومه على الوجه الذي يرضيك عنا. اللهم يا رب العالمين كما جمعتنا في هذا الفجر في هذا الجمع الفضيل أن تجمعنا يا رب العالمين في مستقر رحمتك في الفردوس الأعلى يا رب العالمين. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم وأقم الصلاة.